famous actress Monica Vitti made a series of revolutionary films throughout the 1960s. This led her to have a very important status in the Italian film industry. Stick around to find out how this actress became a global star even though her family was against it. Monica was brought up in a strict household. Monica was born in Rome in 1931. Her upbringing was very different from most children, as she had a pretty miserable childhood. Her family would often bully and belittle her. When speaking about this, Monica even revealed that her mother would be her greatest enemy, and they would have massive fights together. Because she was the only daughter of three children, Monica's parents treated her worse than her brothers. When talking about her childhood, the actress claimed that her family would give her brothers all the independence and power they could have, but on the other hand, would treat her quite differently. They would usually put strict rules for her to follow and even abused her when she didn't behave correctly. This led Monica to think of herself as a powerless person who was incapable of doing anything in life. Her family traumatized her so much, she would have it hard to create a family of her own later on in life. When Monica was in her mid-teens, she attended drama classes, where she found acting as an amazing way to help her in escaping the reality she had to face with her family. During this time, Monica made her first professional debut when she performed on stage in front of an audience. The actress would soon discover that she loved entertaining people and making them laugh with her performances. Unfortunately, by the end of the day, she was still forced to return home and face her daily troubles. The day Monica turned 18 years old, her parents decided to move to the United States in hopes of a better life. Monica wouldn't spend much time in America and would later head off to Germany, where she would group up with other Italian actors and artists of the time and tour across Europe. Throughout this experience, the actress came up with her stage name she is known as by now. Touring led her to meet a lot of people, and in the mid-50s, she was offered to play in La Mandragola by Machiavelli. But soon after her appearance in the film, she would struggle to get cast in other movies, so she decided to start performing in theaters to be able to afford her independent lifestyle. In the late 1950s, she managed to get hired in a couple of films and shows, but her appearance was so insignificant, she failed to receive almost any recognition. She hit a high point in her career after meeting Michelangelo Antonioni. Monica was spotted by Michelangelo in 1957. The director then offered her a role in one of his upcoming films called The Crain. The role she had to play was also insignificant, as she only had to dub the voice of a reporter. But the moment she was backstage and rehearsing her lines, Michelangelo became convinced that she would make a great lead actress. So, he decided to give her bigger roles in his movies. This decision would later boost up Monica's acting career. Even though Monica and Michelangelo came from two completely different backgrounds, they both loved creating documentaries and writing scripts for screenplays. The pair realized that they had a lot in common when it came to their love for working in the film industry. This eventually led both of them to fall in love with each other both professionally and personally. They collaborated on a film called La Ventura, which took almost 2 years to produce. In an interview she made later on in life, Monica claimed that nobody was willing to give her a chance in acting a lead role except for Michelangelo Antonioni. But her collaboration was two-sided. Not only did Michelangelo make Monica a better actress, but she made him a more successful director. The film La Aventura they produced together didn't gain a lot of recognition. Many viewers criticized it, but this soon changed when a group of famous filmmakers realized that the film could be a major hit. Even though the critics were anxious to show support for the director, they were surprised at the level of hostility the film portrayed. Because of all this attention, the film went on to be nominated for the second greatest film ever made in Italy and even won a special jewelry award. A few years later, Monica even won the Golden Globe Award for Best Actress for her performance in the film. Monica continued to collaborate with Michelangelo Antonioni in the next decade. After making a lot of money from her first project with Michelangelo, Monica decided to buy an apartment in Rome. Even though Michelangelo had already proposed to her to get married and live together, her haunting past would persuade her to avoid this at all costs. Since Michelangelo was determined to live with a charming actress, he bought an apartment right next to her and built a staircase inside to connect the houses. Both of them continued to collaborate in numerous films for over a decade before they decided to end their relationship. Before they could break up for good, Monica decided to make an unexpected change in her career. Because she had been present in numerous films, her reputation grew and the number of Italian directors that wanted to work with her also increased. Monica was even offered to act in Hollywood movies, but refused in fear of getting typecast. This fear was also the reason that led her to split up with Michelangelo and focus more on creating comedy and drama films. When speaking about this, she said the decision came purely out of the love she had for making people laugh. Monica's ability to shift tragic roles so that the public could laugh was quite impressive, but the actress only understood this after she had become a massive success throughout her home country. Before the mid-1960s would reach and the comedy genre alla italiana would blow up, Monica had already appeared in such films. This made her one of the first actresses to work in this kind of genre, which led her to be massively successful. During the early 70s, Monica also tried to work with other European directors, and in 1974, she released the film called The Phantom of Liberty. However, outside of Italy, she was remembered for her appearance in the film Modesty Blaze. The actress started fading away throughout the 80s, as she didn't take part in films a lot. One of her last appearances in films was one of Michelangelo's projects. Monica then decided to announce her retirement from the industry and continued working as a teacher and performer in theaters. Throughout her career, she has also attempted to become a director and screenwriter, but they didn't result as successfully as her acting abilities. She finally decided to get married to Roberto Russo, whom she had been dating for over 10 years. But just a couple of years after her marriage, she was diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease. A tribute to Monica Vitti. A lot has been written about Michelangelo Antonioni's films, but the saddest part about it is that they don't talk much about the iconic actress behind all of it, Monica Vitti. Both of them had a strong bond together and even considered each other as their twin flame. And even though there is plenty of footage out there about many Italian actresses, almost nothing can be found about Monica. Information about her is scarce, but she will remain as one of the most inspiring Italian actresses of all time. Well, that's a wrap for this video, guys. If you enjoyed it, keep on watching the next video in this series.